nice gong, everybody. Let her hear it.
Hey, how you guys doing? I just got my hair done, so I was like, I guess I'll do a spot at the Indy. I want to show off. Didn't have any other things planned. I sent a picture to my dad, and he said no, because this was like I put out hair, I think. Or something. I don't know. He didn't like it, so. So, do we have any squirters in here? It's okay. It's cool. You should tell everybody if you can. I actually trained myself how to squirt. You can do that. You just live and let God. And yeah, just don't worry about it. Whatever happens. I trained myself to squirt because I was getting too lazy to go to the bathroom after sex. But everybody's like, what is it? Is it piss? Is it something else? Like, scientists can't figure it out. But I know what it is. It's made out of wifey material. Okay. You guys having fun yet? I am. All right, let's go. Do you guys believe in cancel culture? No? I do. I think it's real. Because if it wasn't real, then why did the guy that molested me die of cancer, you know? I'm just kidding, he didn't. His wife did. Women are always taking the fall for men. So. He did, however, move to Japan, which I thought was weird. You know, different kind of culture there. But my dad found out, and he was like, I'm going to fly to Japan, and I'm going to beat him into an inch of his life. And I was like, that sounds so expensive. Could we go to Lake Tahoe instead? Could help me heal. I told one of my friends that getting molested didn't affect me, and she said, yes, it did. I was like, word. So my dad also, he recently told me that God answers all of your prayers. He just says no sometimes. So I just think it's really funny because I imagine like this little kid, like he's sick and he's praying to God, like, God, please help me get better. And God's just like up in heaven, like, fuck that kid. Don't worry about that kid. I made him up. The kid is fine. And then like I imagine like me like crawling around my room in the middle of January, looking through my jean shorts pockets, like, God, please let there be a crumb of Xanax in this lint I'm about to eat. And God's like, I'm gonna give her the W. And I'm like, the body, Christ. I don't know, I'm not Catholic. I don't know what the W is. Anyway, I don't have a drinking problem. I've got a drinking solution. It's to a drug problem. You heard about the lint. It's not good. It's not a good solution. But quitting drugs, like, I feel like quitting drugs was really easy because all I had to do was, like, you know, like, delete some phone numbers and have some seizures. Cold turkey. But like quitting drinking is gonna be like really hard because like I already miss the guys at the liquor store telling me I'm beautiful. we're going through a breakup because they did not tell me I'm pretty, and they didn't call me baby or make me uncomfortable the last time I went there. I was like, you're dragging me to drink. I started going to AA. Can clap. I forgot what I was gonna say. So that worked. The first time I went, the lady who was running it, she told me she was impressed with how vulnerable I was, and I was like, oh no, I'm addicted to being vulnerable too. I'm doing it right now. Okay, thank you guys. You guys have been awesome.
Here we go with Grace Scott, everybody. Oh, yeah. Very excited. Our featured comic tonight.